See, till now you are familiar with the list, you are familiar with the tuple, you are familiar with the set, you are familiar with the dictionary, you are familiar with the string. More or less you are familiar with all these concepts. But in all these concepts, some more advanced terms are there, like we need to define how to delete the value, how to use the pop-up method, how we can use the nested list, can we make the changes with the tuple? Like tuple is non-mutable. Can we make any changes with the tuple? How we can add the value with the set? How can remove the value from the dictionary? How we can handle the string? So now some advanced concepts regarding these things are there. So I'm just going to make it complete that. See, the first thing that we need to understand, like a list. Already you are familiar with, for the list, what we need to use. We just need to use this parenthesis over there. If I need to create the empty list, how we can do that? To make the empty list or the blank list, what we can use? I'm just going to write my underscore list is equal to, it's a blank list. If I need to put the list with the integer value, I'm just going to use my underscore list one is equal to, like I'm going to give 1, 2, 3. This is what? This is the list with the integer value. Suppose I'm going to use my underscore list is equal to, I'm going to use 1, high, and I'm going to give the value like this. This is again the list with the mixed data type. It's a list with the mixed data type. It's a list with the integer. It's a blank list. This one is the empty one. Now, one important thing is there. We are having the concept of nested list. What exactly the nested list is? Suppose I'm going to use my underscore list. My underscore list 3 is equal to, and I'm just going to use like A, comma, B, comma. And again, I'm going to give some another values over there. So this is what, this is the concept of nested list. This is the concept of nested list. Again, I'm going to give the value like T. Again, I'm going to give the value like Y. So this is what, this is the concept of nested list. So this is the blank list. This is the list with the integer values. This is the list with the mixed data type. And this is what, this is your nested list. Now, if I'm going to print the value, print, I'm just going to use my underscore list. If I'm going to use print my underscore list, file, save this, save, and I'm going to execute this. See, we are getting the value like this, AB 2233445. Now, the next thing is list index. How we can access the value from the list? Naturally, we need to use the list index over there. Suppose I'm writing my underscore list 3 of, I want to get the value of 0, 0 index. So what will be the output? I will get A. Suppose I'm going to use, I'm just going to make it comment. I'm going to use my list of 1. What I will get? It's B. Suppose I'm going to use my list of 2. What I will get? We will get all these values. Run this. I'm writing print my list of 0, print my list of 1, I'm writing print my list of 2. Run this. See, we are getting A, B, and we are getting all these values because it's a nested list. It's available on the index 2. Now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to use print my list of 3, 2, and from the 2, I'm writing 2 over there. So this is your 0, this is your 1, and this is your 2. So what will be the output of this? It's 44. See, we are getting the 44. To get the value from the nested index, we can use like this. This is on the second position. In the second position, again we are writing 2. So in the second position, this is the first one, 0, 1, 2. That's why we are getting 44 over there. So this is how we can apply the index. Okay, tell me one thing. Like I'm going to use print my underscore list 3 of, I'm going to use minus, I'm going to use 1.0. What will be the output? I'm just going to use 1.0. What will be the output? Yes, please. What will be the output? I'm going to use 1.0.
is it just B?
It's an error. Remember, the index always, it will be the integer value. In the index, we cannot use like 1.0 or 2.0. It's not like that. The important thing is, the index always contain, the index always is represented by the integer only. We cannot apply the float and all. That's we need to take care. It's clear? Yeah. Other than this, what we are having, like we are having the concept of negative indexing, you are already familiar with. Suppose I am writing print my underscore list of, my underscore list of. So this is basically the error, always you need to remember. My underscore list 3 of, suppose I am using minus 1. It will work for me, as such there is no any problem, we are getting y. So this is what, this is your negative indexing. And again, suppose we are using, normally we use the term slash list in Python. Slashing means what? Suppose I am writing print my underscore list. Suppose we are using my underscore list 2 colon 3, or we are using 1 colon 2. This is what? This is the slashing. We are writing 1 colon 2. See? It's my underscore list 3. Run this. What we are getting? We are getting B. Why we are getting B? Because from 1 to 2, like this is in this position. Suppose I am writing my list of 1 colon. What we are getting? From this position we are getting every value. This is the first position. And from this position, we are getting every value over there. Suppose we are using print. I am writing my list of 3 colon. What will be the output? We are getting all the values. If we are using print my list of colon 1, colon 3, run this, we are getting all these values. 0, 1, 2. The 3 values we will get. So this is what? This is slashing the list. Slashing means what? We are breaking the list from the particular position and all. Now, suppose we are having the list. I am using m is equal to 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma 4. I am using print sum of m. So sum function is there. It will display the sum of the values. What we are getting? We are getting 15. suppose we are using print. Suppose we are using print max of m. We are getting the maximum value in that particular list. Suppose we are using print min of m. We are getting 1. This is the minimum value we are having. Suppose we are using print. I am using m dot count.
It's L-E-N.
Okay.
Yeah.
We are getting the length. How many values are there? So basically what I'm trying to say, like in the list, you can apply sum, max, min. These are the functions that we can apply over there. Now, after the list, the next thing we are having, it's a tuple. So the important thing in the entire episode was we can use the nested list. In the nested list, how do we can display the values? That we need to take care. We are familiar with all these things. Like these are the functions that we can apply over there. Now the next thing is tuple. Remember, tuple is similar like list. But again, the difference is like in tuple, you can't make any changes over there. It's by default non-mutable. The advantage of tuple is, like, what is the advantage of tuple? Advantage of tuple is, it's little bit faster in compared to list. Because in the list, it's mutable. You can make changes over there. That's why tuple, we can't make any changes with that. So it's more or less, it's a kind of fixed kind of thing is there. So the simple advantage is it's a little bit faster in compared to the list that we need to take care. See, we are using, you are familiar with this, like I'm going to use m is equal to. This is the tuple. I'm going to use print m. Yeah, we are getting all these value. Suppose I'm going to use print m of 0. Now we can apply the index like a list only. Again, we are having the nested tuple is also there. Suppose I'm going to use m is equal to 1, 2, 3, comma. Within the tuple, we can apply the list also. And again, I'm going to give the value. If I'm going to use print m, we are getting all these value. If I'm going to use m of 0 is equal to 100, you will get the error. But if I'm going to remember, we can't make any changes with the tuple.
Cannot make any changes, yeah.
But in the tuple we are having the list. We can make the change with the list. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use 0, 1, 2, 3. I'm writing m of 3, comma 2. And I'm just going to give the value like Santosh. And finally, I'm writing print over there. Run this. See. So if anyone is asking you, like, can we make any changes with the tuple? If it's tuple, then we can't change. But within the tuple, we can use the list. And we can make changes with the list. So this is the thing that we need to remember. The remaining, everything is just, okay. We can also create the list like this, tuple like this, m is equal to, and in the place of this, what we can use? We can use list within a list, nested list. Now in this particular case, we can't make any changes because it's not a tuple. It's not a list within the tuple. It's a tuple within a tuple. So we can't make the changes over here. Now you will get the error. Because you are using tuple within a tuple. In the tuple, we can't make changes. If within the tuple, the list is there, we can make the changes with that. That we need to take care. It's clear? The negative indexing and all, it's just like that.
I have a question.
Yes, yes.
Can you also put a tuple within the list?
Do that. Suppose I'm going to use a is equal to 112233. Now I'm going to use parenthesis. Close this. Print A. We are getting this value.
Oh, okay.
Now we can make the changes over there. Mm-hmm. That's a good question. Like we are having 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So I'm going to use 4. Within 4, 2, I'm going to use like Santosh. Will it allow me to do that?
Maybe not.
Because, no. Because it's a tuple is there. In tuple, we can't make the changes. Mm. So that we need to take care. So we can use the tuple within list. That's not a problem. One important thing is there, like we can create tuple without parenthesis. Even without parenthesis, we can create the tuple. And that concept is known as tuple packing. That concept is known as tuple packing. Tuple packing means what? You are packing the tuple without any parenthesis. So, how we can do this? Suppose I am writing z is equal to 112233 Robin. Now I am going to use print z. If I am going to use print type of z, run this. See, by default it's a tuple type. So this concept is what? This is called packing of tuple. Like we are having the tuple packing. The same thing we are having the tuple unpacking. This is the important concept you need to remember for the interview prospect. Like tuple unpacking is also there. Like what I'm going to use. How many values are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm just going to use A, B, C, D is equal to Z. Now I'm going to use print A. I'm going to use print B. I'm going to use print C. Run this. And we are getting each and every value. 11, 22, 33. So this is called tuple unpacking. From the Z, you are getting the values like this. So this is unpacking of the tuple, and this is the packing of the tuple that we need to take care. Now, from the interview point of view, one important thing is there that we need to take care. My question is, how we can create tuple with single element? This is the tricky question. How we can create tuple with single element? Suppose I am going to use t is equal to Santosh, and I am going to, it's a tuple type of t, run this. It's not a tuple, it's a string type. When we are giving the value in the double quotation, by default, it's a string type. So my question is, how we can create the tuple with single element? Remember, we need to use comma over there. So after Santosh, I'm just going to use comma. Run this. Now it's of tuple type. So these three are the interview question. Always you need to remember regarding the tuple. Tuple packing. We can create the tuple without the parenthesis. Tuple unpacking. From the tuple, you can get the value indirectly like this. How many values are there? It's four values there. I'm just writing a comma b comma c comma d is equal to z. Now we are getting this value. Question is, how we can create the tuple with single element? What we need to use? We just need to use the comma over there. Like we are writing t is equal to Santosh. And finally, we need to use comma. If I'm not going to use the comma, by default, it will be of a string type. It's clear. These three are the good concepts that we need to remember. In the tuple, again, we can use like I'm going to use print z of 0. We can use print z of 0. Yeah, we are getting 11. The same way, we can also use the negative indexing over there, z of minus 1. You will get the robin. Yeah, we are getting the robin. So, in the tuple, again, we can apply the negative indexing, we can apply the indexing, we can apply the slashing over there, that we can do. Now, if I need to make changes with the tuple, for that we need to take care, like, we can apply the changes in the list within the tuple. It's not the in the tuple. Remember, we can apply plus operator. We can apply multiplication operator with tuple. Suppose we are using a is equal to 1, 2, 3. Suppose we are using b is equal to 4, 5, 6. Now I'm going to give print a plus b. Run this. We are getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So when we apply the plus operator over there, you will get the concatenated value. You will get the concatenated value. The same way we can apply the multiplication over there. Suppose I'm going to use print. I am writing a. Multiply by 3. Run this. See, we are getting what? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Because we are using a multiply by 3. So we are just going to display the tuple 3 times. So we can apply the plus operator over there and we can apply multiplication operator over there. Suppose, can we apply this plus and multiplication with a list? Try to do that. Suppose I am going to use p is equal to 1, 2, 3. And q is equal to, I am going to use 44, 55, 66. Now I am going to use print p plus q. Run this. We are getting the same value. Suppose I am using print p multiply by 2. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, that we are getting. So we can also apply the plus and multiplication with the list as well as on the tuple. That we need to take care. Now my question is, how to delete the value from the tuple? What I need to do, I need to delete the value from the tuple. Or I want to delete the tuple. So how we can do that? I need to delete the tuple. So how we can do that? I am writing del. Del. The name of the tuple. A. Now if I am going to use print. A dot. A. we are getting the message A is not defined because it's deleted. So this is how we can delete this. The same way we can delete the list also, like I'm going to use del p, del p, and I'm going to use print p. Again, we are getting the message p is not defined because it's get deleted. So what I'm trying to say, like del method is there, by the use of del method, you can delete the list or you can delete the tuple. Now, one important thing is there, like we are having the w is equal to, I'm going to use, these are the value we are having. Like I'm going to use A, comma B, comma B, comma C, comma D. And I'm going to use print w dot count. Count method is there. And what I need to count, I need to count how many times B is there. I'm just going to count how many times the B is there. Run this and we are getting 2. 2 times the B is there. So we can apply the count over there. So these are the functions that we can apply with the tuple. Any questions, any problem from your side? Everything is fine now. Yes, please.
Yeah. So
can we use the count function with all the data type?
It's not like that. It's not like that. Suppose I'm going to use t is equal to t is equal to 1, 1, t is equal to A, comma, B, comma, C, comma, D, comma, D. If I'm going to use print t dot count, and what I need to count, I need to count the number of occurrence of B. Runs, you're getting 2. So more or less, all the methods that is applicable with the list, that is again applicable with the set, with the tuple. Like count, it's applicable. Like del, it's applicable. Like plus operator, it's applicable. Multiplication operator, it's applicable. But again, this is not applicable. This is basically the concept, tuple packing and packing, and how to create the tuple with a single list. One important thing, like we can also apply the tuple membership test. Tuple membership test. Like we are having A is equal to, these are the value we are having. I'm just going to use print for the membership. I'm just going to use print 88 in A. As such, we don't have. So what the output we will get? False. But if I'm going to use 22 in A, it's a true. So this is also, you can find out the any particular element from this. This is also, you can find out the any elements from the list. We can also iterate all the item from the list, like I'm using for I in A. I'm going to print I. So this is how we can get each and every value from the tuple or from the list. This is how you can get each and every value from the list. And you can also do one thing, like I'm going to use for j in. Here I'm going to define the tuple. Directly I'm going to define the tuple over here. Like I'm going to give Santosh, I'm going to use Asmit, I'm going to use Rajiv. And finally I'm going to use print good morning, good morning, comma, I, j. Good morning, Santosh. Good morning, Asmit. Good morning, Rajiv. So this is how we can apply the tuple over there like this. We can use the, so these are the concept of list and tuple. List and tuple. We need to remember all these methods over there. We just need to remember how to apply the nested list. This is how we can apply the tuple, how we can create the tuple without the parenthesis. What is tuple packing? What is tuple unpacking? How we can apply the del methods and all that we need to take care. It's fine. This is the complete explanation of the list and tuple. After that, now we are having a string, we are having set, and we are having the dictionary. So initially just do one thing, just do the practice with all these stuff, and after that we will go through this in the next session. It's fine.